Hello friends, welcome to Mushkil Ashan. I am Charlotte DeCosta, clinical psychologist, National Institute of Behavioral Sciences. Today we are going to discuss regarding amnesia. Amnesia can be described as the inability of a person to remember events for a period of time. This loss of memory could be caused due to illness, effects of drugs or alcohol, and also often due to brain injuries. So basically, we see that amnesia or memory loss can be due to either organic factors as in structural factors where there is acute coarse brain disease, brain injury, or due to psychogenic, that is psychological factors. Now, how do we distinguish between whether it's due to brain injury, brain disease, or due to psychological factors? Now, when it's due to brain injuries, if you have seen one of our earlier episodes by Dr. Kedar Ranjan Banerjee, he has spoken in details regarding dementia. There we have discussed regarding this segment of amnesia. Brain injury, usually which can be caused due to accidents or some harm. The structure of the brain changes. And this structural change in the brain causes amnesia. Now, this amnesia can be of two types. One is anterograde amnesia, another one is retrograde amnesia. In one, we forget everything that was there before the accident takes place. And in the other, we forget. The short-term memory is usually hampered where after the accident, whatever is happening, we don't remember it for a prolonged period of time. Like these patients usually are unable to answer what they had for lunch or dinner or whom they met yesterday. Now, this forgetfulness is only regarding incidents that occurs after the accident. Not before the accident. Their remote memory is usually fine. They can remember earlier incidents, but their short-term memory or recent memory is hampered. But today what we are going to discuss is amnesia that is caused due to psychogenic or psychological factors. One way how we can distinguish whether it's due to psychogenic or due to organic factors is simple brain MRI or other diagnostic tools that can be used, or EEG, where we find there are certain abnormalities in the brain that can cause amnesia. And sometimes there is no evidence of organic factors. There we are still seeing that the client is forgetting, unable to remember, recognize people, incidents, events. In those cases, we usually conclude that the forgetting is due to psychological factors. Now, before arriving to whether it's due to psychological factors or organic factor, a lot of tests are usually done, psychometry as well as certain other tests of the brain. So many a times we get clients in our clinic who have forgotten regarding their earlier life or are unable to recognize people. Usually the clients that we get who have difficulty with recognizing people have forgotten earlier incidents but have no organic factors involved in it are the forgetting is mostly due to psychological factors. They are usually adolescents. Adolescents who are going to appear for their board examinations, they usually experience these symptoms. Or they may have some interview, or they may have experienced a traumatizing event. They also experience this kind of forgetting. The first thing that has to be kept in mind is that we have to rule out that whether there is a presence of any injury. And once it is determined that there is no injury to the brain, then we start taking a detailed case history, which helps us to get a clear diagnosis. What these adolescents mostly experience could be termed as anxiety amnesia. In cases of severe anxiety, clients may be preoccupied with one's conflict and finds that he or she has only hazy idea of what has happened in the past or no idea at all. In these cases, the parents as well as the caregivers need to be cautious and take the help of a professional as soon as possible. So today we are going to end our session here. If you've liked our video, do like, share and subscribe. And if you have any query, do write to us. We will definitely get back to you. See you next week. Till then, take care and goodbye.